OS is an excellent Android emulator that can run on almost any Android smartphone. This application allows you to run a virtual Android OS directly on your smartphone. In addition, the Android system on VMOS is not linked or controlled with the operating system of the phone. This means that you can make adjustments and perform any operations on the VMOS application without affecting the system on the smartphone. Since Android operating system in VMOS runs independently, you can activate the root user on the Android operating system with one click, therefore, enabling you to run applications that require root user access. You can test the root application in VMOS before installing or rooting the device. But how to run a virtual machine on an Android phone? Is that possible? In this evaluation, we tested VMOS, virtual machine for Android, to see its performance and whether it is really useful to run the virtual machine on the phone. VMOS allows you to run a virtual Android operating system on an Android phone. Since the virtual machine is very resource intensive, this will only work well on an Android phone with great specs. If your phone has less than 3 GB of RAM and 32 GB of memory, you will not be able to run VMOS. There are several benefits to running a virtual machine on your phone. 1. Run two instances of the application at the same time. This means that you need to run several instances of the application. You can have two Facebook accounts, one for family and one for work, and you want to access them at the same time. Or, you probably have two instances of the same game running on different accounts. It's best to have access to two Google Play stores to be able to install different sets of apps for different Google accounts. 2. Launch the Google Play Store on an Android phone that does not support the Google Play Store. It's easy to pair the Google Play Store with an Android phone, but there are many Android phones that don't support it. It could be your Amazon phone or even the latest Huawei Mate 30, which is banned by the US government. By running VMOS as a virtual machine on your phone, you can access the Google Play Store to install your apps. 3. Run rooting applications without rooting your phone. VMOS has root access by default. Root access only applies to the virtual machine. Native phone system is not affected, so you can run custom applications that require root privileges without actually rooting your phone. For example, if you want to be completely ad-free, you can install the popular Adaway app and surf the internet in a virtual machine with all ads blocked. 4. The application runs in the background. VMOS is always running in the background. If you have applications that you want to run constantly, VMOS is useful for that. 5. Launch applications in a floating window. If you like multitasking, you can run VMOS in floating window mode, like watching video and checking messages at the same time. VMOS isn't just designed to test root apps on your non-rooted Android smartphone. You can use the virtual Android operating system to run another account on the same device or separate your work from your private life. What do you think of this cool app? Let us know in the comments.